On Friday, we were reading Cleaning Lady to Leading Lady, and we haven't completed yet. So we are going to continue our this chapter. All of you open your books, page 162. The boys, keep your cameras on. Okay. All of you open your books, page 162. Cleaning Lady to Leading Lady. It is a newspaper report about a girl named Sunam. And this report shows her hard work and determination and her courage. Okay. And in paragraph one, we found her starving and freezing to death on the mountains of Himalayas when she found a person who took her from there and rescued Sunan. Okay. She completed a 6-week trek across the mountains into Nepal. Basically, the girl fled from Tibet. Her family was still in Tibet, and she fled from there because when she was 6 or 7 years old, due to Chinese persecution of her family in December 1989. Persecution, I've told you, if you treat somebody cruelly or badly. So the Chinese were treating the people in Tibet cruelly, and so her parents sent her to live at a family friend's house, but they were also not good with Sonam. So that is why she fled from there with two monks and one friend. The two monks were arrested by the police, okay, and she was left on her own. Now I want one student to read paragraph four, page number 163. Who will read? Raise your hand. Yes, Musaf.
The teenager hid from the police in jungle until the rustle of her feet on leaves gave her away, and she suddenly found a torch being shone in her face. Happily, she had been found by another monk who invited
Monk.
her,
It's monk. Okay, monk.
monk who invited her to complete her escape with himself and seven others. I joined them. We slept during the day and walked at night so we would not be seen. Our first 2 weeks were in the jungle, where there were tigers and other dangerous animals. Then we reached the mountains. We only had a biscuit to eat each day. It was snowing and so cold that one of the
Monks.
monks suffered frostbite and was forced to chop off 2 fingers. My face went black and cold and ice.
With cold and ice. Okay, now first I will explain this, then we will continue. Okay. The teenager at the time when Sunam ran away from Tibet, she was a teenager. Okay, so we are talking about the teenager Sunam. The teenager hid from the police in jungle until the rustle of her feet on rustle is the sound. If we are in a jungle and there is nobody around us and we are moving or walking on the leaves, then leaves make a sound, rustling sound. Okay, so the rustle sound is created by the leaves. Of her feet on leaves gave her away, and she suddenly found a torch being shown in her face. So what happened? The teenager, she went in the jungle because she wanted to hide herself from the police. Because of the sound of the leaves, when she was walking on the leaves, she was found by some group of monks. Happily, she had been found by another monk. I've told you the meaning of monk. Monk are the religious persons, men who work in a church, okay? Who invited her to complete her escape with himself and seven others. So there were eight other people, okay? So he invited her to join their group. I joined them. We slept during the day and walked at night so we would not be seen. Why did they sleep during the day and walked at night so that nobody could see them, okay? Because in the daylight, anybody could see them. So they decided that they would sleep at night. They would sleep during the day and walked at night. Our first 2 weeks were in the jungle, where there were tigers and other dangerous animals. Obviously, the woods and the jungles, there are dangerous animals. So she said that we spent 2 weeks in the jungle. There were tigers and other dangerous animals. Then we reached the mountains. We only had a biscuit to eat each day. So you can imagine their condition, so that they had just a biscuit to eat in a day. Just a biscuit. It was snowing and so cold that one of the monks suffered frostbite. Frostbite is a condition when your skin and tissues of your body are frozen because of cold. It was so cold that the monks suffered frostbite, and in the frostbite, you need to cut off your body parts so that it would not circulate in your blood. So what happened? The monk has to force to chop off. Chop off means cut. Chop off means cut, two fingers. My face went black with cold and ice. If you've noticed, Pakistan is not that much cold, but if you just notice that if we go to some very cold area where it is snowing and we are just walking outside, then our face starts changing its color. So Sunam's face color also changed to black because of cold and because of ice. Now Muzammil. Paragraph 5.
Yes, teacher. Sunam called her darkest hour. We were climbing up and down, up and down. I became exhausted, paralyzed, so I couldn't walk anymore. I was in the middle of the mountains. I thought it was my destiny to die this way. Either the animals would come to eat me or I would freeze to death. I wasn't afraid. My mind was blocked, almost numb. My heart was the Dalai Lama, I told the monk. I couldn't walk anymore. And he turned back, picked me up and carried me. We found a safe place by a river and spent 2 days recovering. At the border, the Nepalese police arrested us and locked us in a cell for a night. After they had taken all our money and jewelry, they let us go in Kathmandu. I couldn't walk because my feet were bleeding and swollen. My foot is still scarred today.
Okay. Now paragraph 5. Sunam recalled her darkest hour. Darkest hour, like when she suffered a lot, when she was about to die. We were climbing because first she hid in the jungle, then she was found by a group of monks. They traveled at night and they slept during the day, and they were dangerous animals in the jungle, but they survived. Then they started climbing up and down the mountains. I became exhausted. Exhausted means extremely tired, too much tired, paralyzed. When you are paralyzed, it means your body parts are not working properly. So she said that I became exhausted and paralyzed, so I couldn't walk anymore. I didn't have the energy to continue my journey. I was in the middle of the mountains. I thought it was my destiny. Destiny is your fate, your luck, to die this way. So she began to think that she is going to die. And it was her destiny to die in this manner, lying in the mountains with no family members around her, all alone. Either the animals would come to eat me up or I would freeze to death. Because obviously it was extremely, extremely cold. It was continuously snowing. So she thought that either the animals would come and eat her up or she would die because of the snow, because of cold. I wasn't afraid. My mind was blocked. I almost numb. Numb means when you cannot think. When you cannot speak, you don't have any ability to do anything. Like her mind was completely blocked, shut off. My heart was with the Dalai Lama. Dalai Lama is the spiritual leader of Tibet, okay? A spiritual person is one who guides you to do good deeds and to avoid bad deeds. Okay, so she said that my heart was with the Dalai Lama. I told the monk I couldn't walk anymore, and he turned back, picked me up, and carried me. So she said to the monk that she was unable to walk, so he turned back and he picked her up. We found a safe place by a river and spent 2 days recovering. At the border, the Nepalese, because they were entering from Tibet into Nepal. At the border, the Nepalese, at the Nepal border, the border of Nepal. The Nepalese police arrested us and locked us in a cell for a night. Cell means prison, okay? So they found a safe place by the riverside and they spent 2 days over there. When finally they entered the border of Nepal, they were arrested by the Nepalese police who arrested them and put them in the bars. After they had taken all our money and jewelry, they let us go in Kathmandu. Kathmandu is the city of Nepal. So the police officers, they took the money and the jewelry of them and they allowed them to go. I couldn't walk because my feet were bleeding and swollen. My foot is still scarred today. Scarred means having marks. Marks left on your body parts after an injury. Okay, so she said that still, even today, my foot is still scarred today. There are still marks on my feet, on my foot. Now, paragraph number 6. Raise your hand. Who will read? Yes, Tahir.
Yes, teacher. In 1997, Sunem went to live in France and afterwards moved to Britain. When she married and settled in Brighton, her passion is music. She writes songs, many mourning her homeland. Mourning her homelands, like performs live and has released 2 CDs. Sunem said, I am working very hard here. I get up at 4 a.m. and use the time to pray, meditate and practice.
Good, Tahir. Okay. In 1997, Sunem went to live in France and afterwards moved to Britain, where she married and settled in Brighton. Okay. So first in 1997, Sunem, she went to live in France and then she went and settled in Britain. In Britain, she married and settled in Brighton. Her passion is music. Passion, your love for something. Okay, some people's passion is to join army. Some passion is to serve humanity. Okay, so her passion is music. In paragraph 2, we read on Friday that she was performing live in the Royal Opera House in London's Covent Garden. Okay, so she writes songs now. We are talking about right now. Okay, she writes songs, many mourning. Mourning means sadness. Her homeland's plight. Plight means unpleasant condition. So mostly she writes songs about her hometown, about Tibet, about her family, because obviously she misses her hometown like Tibet and the people over there. Performs live and has released 2 CDs. Now she has released 2 CDs. Sunem said, I'm working very hard here. She says that I'm extremely working hard. Why? Because she wants to raise money. She wants to gather money. I get up at 4 a.m. Can you imagine? Every day she gets up at 4 o'clock and use the time to pray, meditate, and practice. She prays. Meditate means like when you are sitting all alone and you are thinking about every other single thing, and practice. Last paragraph, now from girls. Yes, Roma. Roma, unmute your mic. Yes.
Sunam's mother died when she was 11, but her father, sister, and 3 brothers remain in the Tibetan countryside. For years.
Years. For years,
she was unsure if they were still alive. But 6 months ago, she made contract. I had sent letter for years, never knowing if they got them. Then I managed to reach them by phone. I spoke my sister for four hours. The telephone bill was 700 pounds.
This symbol is pounds, British currency. Okay, pounds.
The telephone bill is 700 pounds, but it was worth it. They knew I was alive, but don't know anything about me. But didn't know anything about me. My heart is still in Tibet. Tibet. And when it is free, I go back to help in whatever way I can. Sunam has a daughter. But the child was abandoned by her father when she was 6 months old. Sunam could not afford to feed the baby without the support of its father, and had to surrender her to a family friend. Sunam succeeded in visiting her doctor for 10 days last June. I'm working very hard at the same time as performing to raise enough money to bring my daughter to Britain to be with me.
Okay. I'll explain it, then we'll start with the question answers. Sunam's mother died when she was 11, but her father, sister, and three brothers remain in the Tibetan countryside. So Sunam's mother died when she was 11 years old, but she still has brothers, three brothers, a sister, and her father who were still in Tibet. For years, she was unsure if they were still alive, but 6 months ago, she made contact. For many years, she didn't know if her family members were still alive, were they alive or dead. But since 6 months before, she made a contact with her sister. I had sent letters for years, never knowing if they got them. Then I managed to reach them by phone. Okay, she wrote letters to them, but she wasn't sure okay, whether they got the letters, they received the letters or not. So she managed to reach them by phone. I spoke to my sister for 4 hours, obviously after a long, long time. Like when she was 6 or 7 years old, she went to live at a family friend's house. And then now she's 28 years old and she managed to reach her sister. The telephone bill was 700 pounds, but it was worth it. Worth it? Valuable. So talking to her sister was more important for her than the bill. They knew I was alive, but didn't know anything about me. My heart is still in Tibet. And when it is free, I'll go back to help in whatever way I can. So Sunam still is working very hard because she believes that she must go back to her home country, to Tibet. Sunam has a daughter, but the child was abandoned. When she got married, she has a daughter also, but the child was abandoned. Abandoned means left alone by her father when she was 6 months old. So her father left the child alone when she was only 6 months old. So Sunam could not afford to feed the baby without the support of its father and had to surrender her to a family friend. So she had to give her daughter to a family friend so that they could look after her because she was working so much hard that she could not look after her daughter. Sunam succeeded in visiting her daughter for 10 days last June. I'm working very hard at the same time as performing to raise enough money to bring my daughter to Britain to be with me. Okay? So basically in this news report is about a girl called Sunam when she was very small, 6 or 7 years old, and due to Chinese persecution of her family, She was sent to live at a family friend's house, and there she was treated very badly. All the day she had to do washing, cleaning, everything. Then after several years, like when she was 15 or 16, she ran away from there with two monks and one friend, but they were arrested by the police. So she was left alone. She walked in the jungle. She decided to hide herself in the jungle from the police. Over there, she was found by a group of monks, and they asked her to join them. They were also going to Nepal. So she faced a lot of dangers in the jungle as well as in the mountains. She was exhausted and paralyzed. She thought that it was her destiny to die in this manner. But fortunately, she was saved, and they were arrested. When they reached the border of Nepal, they were arrested by the police. But the police, they took the money and jewelry from them and released them. Nowadays, Sunam is working very hard. She is a musician and a singer as well. She is writing songs, and mostly the songs are about her homeland, okay? And she just wants to raise enough money so that she can bring her daughter to, so she can live with her daughter, and she also wants to go and visit her family. So students, I have sent you the notes. Misery chapter we haven't done, but the syllabus I have written so that you can be sure enough that these chapters we have covered so far. Misery chapter we will inshallah read either this week or next week. Okay? Now, any other confusion? Have you got the notes?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Okay.
Yes.
Now, question answers I've also sent you, but don't look into those question answers. What is the difference between a cleaning lady and a leading lady? Yes. Who will tell me? Yes, Muzammil. What is the difference between a cleaning lady and a leading lady?
She can attack.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Just yeah. Discussion. Huh?
A cleaning lady is the which cleans the floor and bathrooms and
buildings, floors, houses, roads. Okay, cleaning lady is one who earns money by cleaning the floors, sweeping the floors, okay, keeping the buildings, malls clean. And who is a leading lady?
That leads.
Okay, who leads? Lead is like a leader. Who is a leader? And leader is one who is followed by the people. People follow a leader. Okay? So she was like a cleaning lady because she worked very hard. She even cleans the floors, the buildings, everything like that. And then she starts writing songs, and now she's performing also, and she's raising enough money. Okay? Good, Tahir. Next question. What had happened to bring the teenage Sonam to the mountains where she was lying down to die? Why Sonam was in the mountains? Why was she in the mountains? Yes, Roma?
So she wants to die because she can't meet her sister, brother, and her daughter. That's why.
No. Any other student? Yes, any other student, raise your hand. Yes. Actually, the reason was that she was badly treated when due to Chinese persecution of her family. She was badly treated at a family friend's house. She had to do all the household work, cleaning, washing, everything. So she left she fled from her hometown, and she was found in the, her companions were arrested by the police, and she was left alone to continue her journey. And when she was lying in the mountains, she was found by another group of monks. Okay, so she survived. That is why she survived. Okay, so Why is her singing at the Royal Opera House in London? Find the answer from paragraph 2. Answers are mentioned, paragraph 2. Why is her singing at the Royal Opera House in London so important to Sunam? Why is her singing so important to Sunam? Some other student? Okay, Tahir. Muzammil. Okay, Muzammil.
Teacher, her singing at the Royal Opera House in London is so important to Sunam, teacher, because her passion is music, and teacher, she writes songs and she sings at that in the Royal Opera House and earns money, a lot of money, and she makes CDs.
And she, why basically her singing is so important to her, so that she can raise enough money to bring her daughter to Britain so that she can live with her daughter. And she, to raise enough money. Okay? So that is why okay. She's working so much hard. Good, Muzammil?
Okay.
The next question is, describe some of the dangers and hardships facing Sunam in her escape across the mountains. From paragraphs 3 and paragraph 5, you have to find out what are the dangers and hardships which were faced by Sunam. What hardships she faced when she was in the jungle and when she was in the mountains? Yes, Roma, Tabin. Yes, Roma.
So when she was in the mountains, she was freezing to death, and her hands was freeze, and her heart was going to death like that. And okay. in the jungle, there was monks and
monks
and a lot of dangerous animals.
Okay,
so
good.
You have to escape from them.
So basically the dangers faced by Sunam were when she was in the jungle, they had to walk during the day, and they have to sleep during the day and walked at night, and they had a biscuit for each day, and they were dangerous. Tigers also in the mountains, they just climbed up and down. So she was so much exhausted that she couldn't walk any further, and she thought that she was going to die. Okay, now next question. What kind of music does Sunam write and perform? Paragraph number 6. What kind of music does Sunam write and perform? Yes, Tahir?
Yes, teacher. She writes about the Tibet in the songs.
Any other? Yes, Musaf? Yes, Musaf? I unmuted you.
Yes,
you tell what Tahir has said. You tell what type of songs she writes in paragraph 6. Find the answer in paragraph. Paragraph 6.
Jim Mowring.
Morning. Yes.
Morning, her homeland flight.
Correct. She writes songs, many morning her homeland flight.
CDs.
She has released two CDs.
She and also she performs on her Tibetan mountain songs.
And she performs live. Correct. Good. Last question. What are Sunam's dearest wishes for the future? What are her wishes for the future? What are her wishes for the future? Yes. Tabin, you didn't tell any answer. And Tabin, why your camera is turned off? You have to turn on your camera. Yes, Tabin, speak up. Yes, Muzammil.
Teacher Sunam's dearest wishes for the future are that she wants to raise enough money to bring her daughter to Britain to live with her.
Okay, correct. Her dearest wishes are for the future to bring her to raise enough money to bring her daughter back to Britain to live with her and to meet her family, to raise enough money so that she can go to Tibet to meet her family. Okay?
Okay.
So the chapter is clear to everybody. We have done it. Now, students, what was our last grammar topic which we were doing? I will ask questions from that chapter. Which chapter was our last one? Tenses now? And I've asked you that you have to revise it. Have you learned? Have you learned? Okay. I will check. What is simple present tense and which helping verbs are used in simple present tense? Gee, who will tell me? Simple present tense and which helping verbs are used in simple present tense? Gee. Yes, Muzammil.
Teacher, in simple present tense, the helping verbs used are, is, are, am, with the first form of verb.
Beta, is, are, am is also used in present tense, but it is used in present continuous tense with ing. He is going, I am coming, they are making. Theek hai? In simple present tense, we use the helping verbs do or does. Okay? Do comes with the, yes, do comes with which subject? Do comes with which subject? Singular or plural? Tahir? Yes, Tahir?
First form of verb.
But with the singular subject or plural subject? Yeah, like with I do or he do?
I do.
I do. And with he we put? He? Yes, Musaf? He
will be, shall be.
No, I am not going in the future tense. We are in the present tense. Okay. So with singular subject, we put does. And with plural subject, we put do. Clear to everybody? Simple. Bita dekhe. Simple present tense. Present tense, there are present continuous, present perfect continuous. But simple present is a tense which tells about our habits, general truths,
habitual action,
or routine work. Okay, like whatever you do on daily basis, like you wake up, I go to school, I have my breakfast, I do my homework, I take classes, I go to the park. Okay, these are all go, walk, come, wake. Sleep. These are all verbs in the simple present tense. So there are no other helping verbs. So why we are putting do and does? Because there are no other helping verbs in the simple present tense. So do and does are the helping verbs which are used in negative sentences and interrogative sentences. For example, I give you a simple sentence. I wake up late. Change negative. I do not wake up late. Interrogative, do I wake up late? And Vita, I have asked you people to make sentences. And I will send the homework now also. She sings a song. She does not sing a song. Does she sing a song? In this manner. They write a letter. They do not write a letter. Do they write a letter? Okay. Now, students, what is simple past tense? One second, beta. Yes, Kinza, where is Kinza? Kinza has left. Okay. Yes, beta. What is simple past tense? Yes, Roma. Past.
In simple past tense, I have a sentence.
You can use it.
Mother came home last night.
Correct. Your answer is correct, Peter. Don't be nervous and don't be confused. Just think clearly and logically before speaking, okay? Yes, Roma, your answer is correct. Mother came home late last night. So came is the verb in simple past tense because it is telling about the action of the mother in the past, which happened like yesterday, last night. Muzammil, are you okay? Last week, okay? So we put the simple past tense, means the second form of verb, like buy will become bought, catch, caught, see, saw, do, did. And similarly, the helping verb is did not. With did not, we use which form of verb? With did not, we use which form of verb? No, Tahir. First form of verb. I've told you two past forms cannot come together. So we did not, we put the first form of verb. For example, she bought a camera.
In simple past, in both we use first form of verb.
No. Present, we use the first form because it is present. Happening now. Okay? Daily routine. Which we do on, I read newspaper daily, daily routine. Past,
yes.
Action happened in the past. Yesterday, ago, last day, last week, past tense. But I'm telling you that in past tense, in the negative and interrogative sentences, we did not, because did is already past. So we did not, we put the first form. Because two past forms, grammatically, it becomes wrong. We cannot put together in the same sentence. I'm give you a sentence, I give you in the papers, change it into negative. Suppose the sentence is, Ali bought an apple. Ali bought an apple, past tense. So you know the helping verb is did. Ali did not buy an apple. So you have to change bought into buy. Do you understand? So it will remain. The sentence will remain in the past tense because there is did not, and did not is used in the past tense. Do and does are used in the present tense. Students, unless and until you will practice these tenses, you are not going to understand or learn them. I have told you, write maximum examples. Make three columns. First, make a column, simple present. Simple past, simple future. Then write an example in the simple present. For example, Zara watches television. The same sentence in simple past, Zara watched television. Then in future, Zara will watch television. In this way. Do you understand? Okay, that's simple present. First form of verb, Zara watches television. It's her habit. She watches television. Zara watched television yesterday. Telling about the past tense. She watched. Zara will watch television. Telling about her action in the future. Tahir, be very careful. Will cannot be used in the present and in the past tense. Will, wherever the verb will comes, it means future tense. Clear to everybody? Okay. So, any other thing you want to discuss, because it is about to end, your class is about to end. I've unmuted all. Any question you want to ask me, one by one you can ask. If any confusion.
No.
No? Okay. Yes, Muzammil, Roma, any person? Okay, beta. Now you have to do all your homework.